things. It's just, I'm a bit, I've never been awestruck, I suppose.
It's beautiful. It's gone just a big step upwards in luxury. And as always, the decor always looks fantastic, well finished. So big.
Nice and shiny.
What a great feel.
Welcome aboard.
You're going to love this boat.
This is just a little bit bigger.
Oh, have a look. Jeez, welcome to my world.
How exciting.
It is exciting.
It's a bloody big factory. Jenny was saying, I thought it was just this office here. I said, no, it's full of factories all around it. This is number 7. It's about 15 years. We started with a 33 flybridge, 42 flybridge. We went to a 51 flybridge. We went down to a 5,000. That wasn't big enough. So we went to the 56. I only had that for 7 years, but the 575 came along and was pretty fast. Had a cruise speed of 30 knots, so I went for that. I was here picking up the 575 and was standing up at the fuel dock over there at Riv, and they were filling the boat up for me. And Wes came over to me. He said, you know, I've got a bit of a secret to tell you. And I said, oh, yeah. He said we're going to do a 645. I said, oh, it's going to be a flybridge or a sedan then? And he said, a flybridge. I said, will you give me a ring when you decide to do an SUV? And I think it might have been 18 months to the day. I had just come back from Metung on a raft up, and I had Stuart on the boat, the dealer from Melbourne. And he says, I've got Wes on the phone. I said, what's he want? He says, they're going to do an SUV. For 2 days, I thought about it. Then I went in and saw Stuart, and I said, you better get Wes on the phone. And I said, Wes, get me one. I reckon this is the ultimate cruising boat. It ticks all the boxes. You've got the fuel. All the other boats I've had, I've never been able to use the front foredeck. Here, I've got a lounge up there. I can sit, I don't know, 14 people up there, I think. And then I've got the cockpit out the back here where I can sit people, or they can come into the lounge in here. As Jenny said, it's like a hotel room. Only you can move it anywhere you like.
Since we've had Rivieras, we've been able to include family and friends, and that is the most important to us, being out with a group and have that welcome champagne and everybody relax and everybody feel part of it. You can still have your quiet areas if you want to drift off and fall asleep with the sound of the waves. But it's just wonderful to all be together, and I think that's the best thing for me about boating.
It's world-class standards, Australian product. It's as good as anything else out in the market. New technology comes along, and it comes along in Riviera. They seem to upgrade all the time. I said, I need a heated tail rail. So that's standard. But you've got the fly screens over the portholes. He said, oh, that's standard. As you get the boats and you go along, you find out what you haven't got, and the SUVs seem to put everything in there. I probably wouldn't have bought all the boats I bought from Riviera if it wasn't for Stuart.
We're lucky that Stuart had the right know-how, because Ray was pressured by a dealer for other companies and they hounded him.
I was with Stuart, we'd just been out for a trial run, we're coming back and the guy rang me from the other crowd, and I was supposed to go and have a test drive of it the next day. He must have rang me 3 or 4 times and everything. I said, oh, forget it, don't worry about it. He says, I'm going to buy a Riv. And Stuart was sitting next to me. And he said, oh, thanks very much, Ray. And that was it. That's how that one happened. You talk to people with boats and just ask them how they go sometimes. Some of the dealers get their commission and they're gone. They don't want to know you. Riviera, you know, I've been up in Sydney, and the dealer up in Sydney, Stuart rings the dealer and get in contact with a dealer, and they chase up things for you. You know, if you need some parts or whatever, you're chasing something, you know, you can get it in Sydney. You can get it anywhere up the East Coast. I think I want to get up to Hamilton Island and do an overnight and take the family out. 11 of us on the boat. Spend a night out there underneath the stars. If you're out there and you're thinking you're going to buy yourself a boat, buy an Australian product that's world class. And you've got a dealership right around Australia. Now you've got $1 million investment and you want to keep it looking nice. It's a big thing with a boat. Keep your money in Australia and just buy Australia.
I'm glad we did find Riviera. It's paid off.